I'm not going to tell you a favourite film flan memory.
Should I put on my shades?
I lost my best flan memory because I've got flamnesia. That didn't sound right. Flamnesia.
Oh, excitement behind us there.
Okay, it does work. Okay, I'll do it again.
Oh, somebody going into court, not somebody going to the flan.
Flamnesia.
I won 2 years ago. I won the Prettiest Volunteer of the Year award.
That is flan.
I don't have a best flan memory because I have flamnesia.
That is pretty flaw for a white guy, yeah. That's my new favourite flaw memory, is that moment, that fun, yeah.
I'm very sorry.
Are you ready?
It's that time of year when the best of cinema, the best ideas and the best visions and images and stories that I've never heard, you get that exposition.
It's a really egalitarian festival. Anybody can be a part of it.
Creativity is a precious thing which needs to be nurtured and which people need to take part in.
The FLA is special in a way, the film FLA, in that it creates an atmosphere which isn't anywhere else.
We can really feel it from the moment we arrived here.
There's a real sense of the whole industry coming together, I think.
You know, we make films for audiences and we've got to make sure that they get seen. I want people to watch my films on a big screen and appreciate it in a cinema, and so do thousands of other young filmmakers. So it's really, really important to have things like the FLA to showcase Irish film, to give young directors a chance to get their work seen.
Galway, to me, apart from fishing, is about film.
There is nothing anywhere in the world like Galway.
Started here in Galway, there was absolutely nothing.
I can remember how exciting it was as well. I can really remember, because at that time as well, you weren't getting to see world cinema.
The strong memories would be the raft, with the films being shown on the raft, which was giving a special atmosphere. Unfortunately, the neighbours then decided to complain and didn't want them in. I think we should have gone for silent films then and still kept them up there.
Little John singing in the rain with a big queue of people all the way down the side wall of the Clada Palace. That was beautiful.
My father was actually an extra on a film called Reefer and the Model. My parents were on one side, and my aunt and uncle were on another, and nobody had seen the film before us, and there was this reasonably explicit, for 1988, sex scene in the middle of it, so nobody knew exactly where to look or what to say or do. We just stayed there, very Irish, and yes, over that.
Well, my favourite film flan memory would have to be 22 years ago, when the whole film FLA actually saved my life. I was recovering from an accident, so I had bandages on both arms. I couldn't drive or do anything, really. So I was able to walk from my house down to the old Clada Palace, where the film FLA at the time was being held. And I went to every movie, I'd say, that went on that year. And then I could just walk back up home again and forget all my troubles and my cares. So it really did save my life that summer. So thanks, Galway Film Fleadh.
There was a great night again at the bar in the Marquee with Michael Moore. We shared a very exotic cigarette and a lot of laughs.
Looking back at it, it was all a bit chaotic in a very lovely type of way. The only thing that hasn't changed is the spirit.
I've been here volunteering at the Fleadh since I was 16. And this is my first year as a staff member. I've got my badge here, and it's something I'm really proud of.
A friend of mine was in one of the Jack Taylor movies, and we didn't get seats together, so we were all sitting apart, and she texted and said, "My bit is just coming up next," and we were all waiting, and she was cut. It was very sad. Maria O'Neill, this is your moment on film.
2 years ago, at 2012 FLA, Aidan Gillen was here for the premiere of The Good Man, I think it's called, and he was standing right beside me, and as the doors opened I said, "Go on in," and as I brought down my hand he just rested against it briefly for a second by accident, and I just touched his bum, and then I kind of pulled it back, and he turned around very quickly and kind of just looked at me and went like, and then just kind of backed away into the doorway, and then I closed the door, and the girl across from me who was volunteering was just like, "What?"
my special moment was seeing Galway's greatest living artist, Peter O'Toole, on stage in the town hall behind us just a few short years ago. The applause for him, the warmth for him, the knowledge of all that he did was just fantastic. It was just glitter, passion, creativity and fun all the way. I'll never forget it.
When we were here 7 years ago, our youngest daughter was with us the whole time, and she was 14 years old, a very important age and an adolescent years. And we took her to all these documentaries. Well, now, you know, we have a Netflix account, and she is a documentary fan. And only by you asking me what my memories were from 7 years ago did I remember, oh, well, what we did 7 years ago is I went to like 3 documentaries a day, and it was wonderful. And then it hit me. That's why our youngest daughter is a documentary fan. So my most interesting memory is the one that you helped create for me by asking me, what do you remember from 7 years ago? And now I understand my daughter better.
And a lot of it is a bit of a haze, you know, a haze of people and just characters you met that slummed with each other in this, you know, manky old tent out at the side of the Cloud of Palace. Rain and muck, you name it, walking on wobbly floorboards. Oh, it was fabulous. Wonderful days. Great memories.
But one of the other memories would be for me was, it would be having my own documentary premiered here, you know, and it was about my dad. And to see my dad up on that big screen and to see him in the audience watching it and taking all that in, you know, that's another beautiful memory.
In 2012, I was scheduled to get surgery. I had to take my final year off college. So my surgery was scheduled for September. And in the middle of me recovering from my surgery, my aunt passed away. So I ended up going back to hospital, complications with the surgery. I came out and had to, you know, okay, I have to go back next year and finish my degree. What do I do? I'm talking to Gar one day. And I say, Gar, I'm looking for an internship in what I do. And he said, well, we're looking for a tech guy. So I started in the FLA in January 2013, and I'm still living my favorite FLA memory.
It's a big part of me, and I hope that I'm a little part of it. So thanks to you guys for taking your time. Yeah, thanks everyone.
Dancing with Angelica Houston. I mean, you know, great. As I was dancing with her, I was thinking, Jack Nicholson danced with this one. You know, so all these lovely memories and all the people that come down, it's just a fantastic experience. Like I said, for me, it'd be the perfect place to die.
Galway, aesthetically, in terms of ethos, in terms of intellectualism, in terms of politics, in terms of anarchy, in terms of everything, basic humanity. I think, and I hate to say this because there are so many other things that you've got to play second by saying it, but I think it's the greatest festival in the world.
It's the excitement, it's the buzz, it's the achievement, it's the failures, it's the whole mix. That's what makes a great artistic event, and I think the FLA has the makings of that, always had, and it's always in the making, and that to me is what all of this works about. And good luck, all of you.